is risen.
The cross is behind.
The stone is rolled away.
The tomb is empty.
And the message is clear.
He is not here.
He is risen.
He is risen indeed.
Here we go. Christ the Lord is risen today. Hallelujah. Son of man and angels say, hallelujah. Raise your joys and triumphs high.
Resurrection Sunday, I welcome you to this service of celebration as we recognize that our Jesus is alive. He is risen, and he will be alive forevermore, and we celebrate that today. So glad that each and every one of you are here today. You know, the Christian family is all about community, and Elim is all about community. It's one of our highest values. And it's the cross and the empty grave of Jesus that binds us together as brothers and sisters in Christ. So today we are having a campus-wide celebration to celebrate the resurrection of Christ. We have some folks from our full care area of Elim here, or some of you right here at the front. But we are shooting live stream over to all of the neighborhoods right now in Harrison and Harrison West. And they are participating in this service with us. We have people from assisted living in the Emerald here with us. And we're also shooting at the live feed over there as well so we can be together. And then we have independent living folks here as well. But we have other people here. We have some family members of people who live here at Elim. We are glad you're here. Thank you for coming. Thank you for joining with us in this time. And we have people who are here simply from the larger Christian community who said, we want to come and worship Jesus here today. So wherever you fit on that spectrum, welcome to this place. A special welcome to the Milne family here. We are so glad that you're here. I was Alistair, Austin, Brooklyn, right? Got it. I was talking with Alistair just a moment ago, and I said, someone had come in here and said, I think when Alistair was a little boy, I heard him sing. And it was true, wasn't it? Yeah. So we're so glad that you can come and both lead us in worship and participate with us in worship. Friends, we are going to have a hopefully a very meaningful time together today. We're going to have a dramatic reading as we celebrate the resurrection. We're going to have some special music from the Milne family. We are going to have different objects put onto the table that will help us to think through what took place that first Easter. We're going to have some video messages that come up on the screen from different folks here in our community as well. And our prayer is that every part of the service would be used by God to touch our hearts, to fill us with joy, to fill us with peace, and just to celebrate the fact that our Lord lives. So, welcome. What we want to do now is watch a couple of video vignettes as people greet us this morning, and then we're going to ask Ron, Elim's CEO, to come up, and he's going to share with us. And after that, we're going to have some special music by the Milne family. So why don't we pray together first, and then we're going to watch the videos. Lord, we are filled with joy this morning because you are alive. And Lord, we know that you were just as alive yesterday as you are today, but today we celebrate in a special way. On Friday, we met together and we put ourselves in the shoes of the disciples and other followers of yours, Lord Jesus, who were devastated, who were crushed, who were filled with sorrow and grief because they didn't yet know Easter. So today, Lord, we want to enter into that joy, having experienced the pain and the darkness of Friday and Saturday. And now celebrate our living Lord. Thank you for each person who is here, and we invite you, Lord, to work in our hearts. May we leave here changed people because we have met with the living Christ. For it's in your name we pray. Amen. I invite you to watch the screen.
My name is Henry, and my wife and I moved in here to the Emerald in 2010 and April the 3rd, between Good Friday and Easter. And my wife, Evangeline, she passed away about 2.5 years after we've been here in 2012 in September. And I decided to stay on, and so I've been living here by myself the last 10 years and enjoying the time and the care that I receive at the Emerald. Since 1947, that's when I accepted the Lord, being convicted of my sin and disobedience to God. And since then, I continue to seek to follow him wholeheartedly. And it means a lot, especially when it comes to Easter time, to take time off and think soberly about what it costs him for me to give his life. And on behalf of myself and all the residents at the Emerald here, the new people and everyone that's been here longer, I invite everyone to join with us to celebrate this Easter season and truly give God the glory for what he accomplished in Christ when he gave his life for us. It's a worth to celebrate and praise the Lord with all our being and strength, as the psalmist says. Amen.
Hi there. I'm Kay Lacasse, and I've lived in the Harrison West 5 years. I like my room. I've been the only one in it, and I like my pastor. It's Easter Sunday, and we are all going to be celebrating because Jesus rose from the dead, and he saved us or gave us a chance to come to him to be his. On behalf of all Full Care, we celebrate and glad we're all here.
Hello, we are Maria and Toos Koppers, and we are a kind of newcomers to Elim. It was about 6 years ago that Maria came home from some meetings here at Elim, and she told me she's written our names down for Elim to get a place here, and I was shocked because I thought I was much too young for going into Elim. But here we are. 6 years later, and we've arrived.
Welcome, everybody, for this wonderful Easter celebration. You know, Easter is the most important event in the year and for the whole world.
So I like Easter a lot because to me it also represents new life. I've got a stick, a walking stick. I don't use it, but it is only a dead piece of wood. And there won't be any leaves coming out, but there is a story in the Old Testament with Aaron where his stock, his staff, started to blossom miraculously out of something that was absolutely dead. New life came and it even bore fruit. So I think about our own lives. We were like dead sticks, nothing more than that. We were dead in our trespasses and sins. But when Jesus came in, he gave us new life. And so we can not only blossom, but we can be bearing fruit in being productive for his kingdom.
We trust that all of you will celebrate this beautiful Easter day with us together, the new life in Christ, and I hope you all have new life in Christ too. Rejoice and praise the Lord forever and ever. The King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
He is risen.
Hallelujah. He is risen.
Yes.
He has risen.
Good morning, everybody. As odd as this is to say, I'm actually the oldest person of all those people at Elim. I've been here longer than all of them. It's quite an accomplishment. I never thought I would be able to say that here. My name's Ron Pike, and for those of you I haven't met, I'm the CEO at Elim Village. And I want to bring you greetings on behalf of all of our staff, as well as our board of directors and everybody associated with Elim. Easter for me is such a great time of the year, a chance to celebrate the greatest story ever told. Isn't it amazing? The story of Jesus, his life, his death, and his resurrection. There's so many aspects to this story that we could talk about for ages, but Pastor Lorne has only given me 2 minutes, so I will keep with that. But as I was reflecting on this and thinking of Easter this year, after having been through COVID, hearing about wars in this world, and all the things that we deal with, there were three words that kind of stuck with me about Easter: love, sacrifice, and hope. And those three have become so important to me over this last year as we work through things in our world, as we work through things in our life. The love that we've been demonstrated through Jesus' life to share with one another, the sacrifice that we're called to for one another, and those things that are so well exemplified in Elim, as Pastor Lorne pointed out earlier, in community. What a great place to be. But today is the day that we celebrate hope and an everlasting relationship with our Creator. Today we celebrate that, which is found through Jesus and his resurrection. What a fantastic day. The last couple of days, I've had the privilege of being in Harrison, up by Harrison Lake, with a couple friends of mine at a cabin. It's not that far away if you really think about it, but when you're there, it feels like it's a world away. To be in the mountains and with the water, with the beautiful blue sky, with the sun, moon, and stars all there. And to think that this Creator who put all of this together calls us into relationship with Him is absolutely amazing. And what's more amazing is to be able to think of that through Jesus Christ, that we will get to see that today, which we see only in a part. We will see that someday fully because of today and because of the resurrection of Jesus. It is truly inspiring for all of us, and I know that all of us together are happy today as we celebrate the resurrection and Easter. Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to sing. Sorry, can you turn on the mic there? You can turn on Brooks too. Thanks, Frank.
Check. Yep. Check, check, check.
All it's right. On. So this one's called O Christ, He is the Fountain. My mom put a little Irish tune to it. Hope that's okay, years ago. And then we sat together and we wrote this little interlude between verses 3 and 4, just so you feel like you're in Ireland. Not that you, well, maybe you don't want to go, but it's a love song to the Lord Jesus Christ. He is risen.
And the crown He giveth more. I'll never be more loved than I am right now. I wasn't holding you up, so there's nothing I can do to let you down. It doesn't take a trophy to make you proud. I'll never be more loved than I am right now.
Going through a storm, but I won't go down. I hear your voice echo through the rhythm of the wind till it calls me out.
You would cross an ocean so I wouldn't drown.
You'll never be closer than you are right now.
'Cause you are Jireh, you are enough. You are Jireh, you are enough, and I will be content in every circumstance. You are Jireh, you are enough, forever enough and always enough, more than enough, forever enough and always enough. More than enough, enough. I don't wanna forget how I feel right now. From the mountaintop, I can see so clear what it's all about. Stay by my side till the sun goes down. Don't wanna forget how I feel right now. Jireh, you are enough. You are Jireh, you are enough. And I will be content in every circumstance. You are Jireh, you are enough. I'm already loved, I'm already chosen. I know who I am, I know what you've spoken. I'm already loved, more than I can imagine. That is enough. I'm already loved, chosen. I know who I am, I know what you've spoken. I'm already loved, more than I can imagine. That is enough. 'Cause you are a Jireh, you are enough. You are Jireh, you are enough, and I will be content in every circumstance. You are Jireh, you are enough. Oh, and I will be content in every circumstance. You are Jireh, you are enough.
We are going to begin a dramatic reading now. And sometimes at the start of a service, someone will say, sit back and enjoy. I don't want to say that today. I want you to participate. I want you to be involved in your spirits worshiping. I want you to be celebrating. As God's people, we just don't sit back. We worship. So let's worship together in this time. We're going to have an interspersing between readings, between congregational songs that will come up on the screen. Pastor Gerald's going to put some items on the table. And we are going to worship our risen Lord. permit us just a brief glance backwards to Good Friday, and then we're going to leap into Easter Sunday with the context of what took place. Jesus died and was buried on Friday.
Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Were you there when they crucified my Lord? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they crucified my Lord?
The next day was the Jewish Sabbath, and a guard was posted to prevent any tampering with the body.
Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Were you there when they laid him in the tomb? Oh, sometimes it causes me to tremble, tremble, tremble. Were you there when they laid him in the tomb?
Then on the first day of the week, Sunday, those who mourned Jesus came to pay their respects.
And were you there when he rose up from the dead? Were you there when he rose up from the dead? Oh, tremble, tremble. Were you there when he rose up from the dead?
When the Sabbath was over, Mary Magdalene, Mary the mother of James, and Salome brought spices so that they might go to anoint Jesus' body. Very early on the first day of the week, just after sunrise, they were on their way to the tomb, and they asked each other,
"Who will roll the stone away from the entrance of the tomb?"
There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven, and going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it.
His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men.
The angel said to the women,
"Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen, just as he said. Come and see the place where he lay. Then go quickly and tell his disciples.
He has risen from the dead and is going ahead of you into Galilee. There you will see him.
Now I have told you." So the women hurried away from the tomb, afraid yet filled with joy, and ran to tell his disciples.
So Peter and the other disciple started for the tomb. Both were running, but the other disciple outran Peter and reached the tomb first. He bent over and looked in at the strips of linen lying there, but did not go in.
Then Simon Peter came along behind him and went straight into the tomb. He saw the strips of linen lying there, as well as the cloth that had been wrapped around Jesus' head. The cloth was still lying in its place, separate from the linen.
Finally, the other disciple, who had reached the tomb first, also went inside. He saw and believed. They still did not understand from Scripture that Jesus had to rise from the dead. And then the disciples went back to where they were staying.
Now Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she wept, she bent over to look into the tomb and saw two angels in white seated where Jesus' body had been, one at the head and the other at the foot.
And they asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?"
"They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they have put him." At this, she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she did not realize that it was Jesus.
He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? Who is it you are looking for?"
Thinking he was the gardener, she said, "Sir, if you have carried him away, tell me where you have put him, and I will get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned toward him and cried out in Aramaic, "Rabboni," which means teacher.
Jesus said, "Do not hold on to me, for I have not yet ascended to the Father. Go instead to my brothers and tell them, 'I am ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God.'"
Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news, "I have seen the Lord," and she told them that he had said these things to her.
My Jesus, I love thee. I know thou art mine. For thee all the follies of sin I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Savior art thou. If ever I love thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. I love thee because thou hast most loved.
Now that same day, two of them were going to a village called Emmaus, about 7 miles from Jerusalem. They were talking with each other about everything that had happened. As they talked and discussed these things with each other, Jesus himself came up and walked along with them, but they were kept from recognizing him.
He asked them, "What are you discussing together as you walk along?"
They stood still, their faces downcast. One of them, named Cleopas, asked him, "Are you the only one visiting Jerusalem who does not know the things that have happened there in these days?"
"What things?" he asked.
"About Jesus of Nazareth," they replied. "He was a prophet, powerful in word and deed before God and all the people. The chief priests and our rulers handed him over to be sentenced to death, and they crucified him. But we had hoped that he was the one who was going to redeem Israel."
"And what is more, It is the third day since all this took place. In addition, some of our women amazed us. They went to the tomb early this morning, but didn't find his body. They came and told us that they'd seen a vision of angels who said he was alive. Then some of our companions went to the tomb and found it just as the women had said, but they did not see Jesus.
He said to them, "How foolish you are, and how slow to believe all that the prophets have spoken. Did not the Messiah have to suffer these things and then enter his glory?"
And beginning with Moses and all the prophets, he explained to them what was said in all the scriptures concerning himself.
As they approached the village to which they were going, Jesus continued on as if he were going farther. But they urged him strongly, "Stay with us, for it is nearly evening. The day is almost over." So he went in to stay with them.
When he was at the table with them, he took bread, gave thanks, broke it, and began to give it to them. And then their eyes were opened, and they recognized him, and he disappeared from their sight.
They asked each other, "Were not our hearts burning within us while he talked with us on the road and opened the scriptures to us?"
They got up and returned at once to Jerusalem. There they found the 11 and those with them assembled together and saying, "It is true. The Lord has risen and appeared to Simeon."
Then the two told what had happened on the way and how Jesus was recognized by them when he broke the bread.
Christ alone, my hope is found. He is my light, my strength, my song. This cornerstone, this solid ground, firm through the fiercest drought and storm. What heights of love, what depths of peace, when fears are still, striving seas, my comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. In Christ alone, who took on flesh, fullness of God in helpless babe, this gift of love and righteousness, scorned by the ones he came to save. Till on that cross, as Jesus died, the wrath of God was satisfied. My comforter, my all in all, here in the love of Christ I stand. There in the ground his body lay, light of the world by darkness slain. Then bursting forth in glorious day, up from the grave he rose again. And as he stands in victory, sin's curse is lost, precious blood of Christ. No guilt in life, no fear in death, this is the power of Christ in me. From life's first cry to final breath, Jesus commands my destiny. No power
While they were still talking about this, Jesus himself stood among them and said to them, "Peace be with you."
They were startled and frightened, thinking they had seen a ghost.
He said to them, "Why are you troubled, and why do doubts rise in your minds? Look at my hands and my feet. It is I myself. Touch me and see. A ghost does not have flesh and bones, as you see I have."
When he had said this, he showed them his hands and feet, and while they still did not believe it, because of joy and amazement,
he asked them, "Do you have anything here to eat?"
They gave him a piece of broiled fish, and he took it and ate it in their presence.
He said to them, "This is what I told you while I was still with you. Everything must be fulfilled that is written about me in the law of Moses, the prophets, and the Psalms."
Then he opened their minds so that they could understand the scriptures.
He told them, "This is what is written. The Messiah will suffer and rise from the dead on the third day, and repentance for the forgiveness of sins will be preached in his name to all nations, beginning at Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. I'm going to send you what my Father has promised, but stay in the city until you've been clothed with power from on high."
Standing in our
We have heard much as scriptures were read. We have sung much. I trust we have felt much. And we have worshiped much. The events of that first Easter more than 2,000 years ago were historic. They were miraculous. They were world-changing. And praise God, they were eternity-changing as well. But the question that remains for each one of us is, how do the events on that first Easter change our lives? Do they change our today? Our tomorrow, our eternity. Because of what Jesus did on Calvary and because of what took place that first Easter, we can not only live victorious lives depending on the resurrection power of Jesus Christ, but we can have a confident assurance that in God's perfect time, when our life on this earth is over, we will be forever with our risen Lord. That's the difference that Easter can make as we put our faith in Jesus and what he did for us. Thank you for coming this morning. Trust that the Holy Spirit has spoken to your heart. I want to invite you as you leave here, if you want some coffee and some tea and a hot cross bun, you are welcome to have one. Let's fellowship together as brothers and sisters in Christ, and let's continue to celebrate the reality that our Lord lives. Alistair, I think you know the chorus, "He is Lord, He is Lord, He is risen from the dead, and He is Lord." Can we just sing that together as a declaration?
So what's the first verse?
He is Lord, He is Lord, He is risen from the dead.
He is Lord.
God's people said, amen. Would you pray with me? Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you are alive and you are here amongst us this morning. We give you praise. We worship you as a risen Savior and as a risen Lord. And we would ask, Lord, that you would give us both the desire and the strength to live our lives in such a way that our lives are an act of worship before you, and that our lives declare that you are alive, that our lives declare that you are risen. And Lord, we look forward to that day when you will return. We thank you, Jesus, for everything that you are to us. And now may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, may the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you now and until Jesus comes again. Amen. Go in peace, my friends.